I'm an independent that leans Republican. Since I spent half my life in Massachusetts and the other half in Georgia, due to the Electoral College, my vote never really did count for much. For that reason, I voted independent. The last time I voted for a president from either party was John McCain. I was not happy about Sarah Palin, but I really liked John McCain. Yes, I liked him even though he was captured. And any politician saying otherwise should not be qualified to run for any office in the United States. Last election, I voted for Gary Johnson for president and the rest Republicans. Now, granted, I did that because I thought Hillary would win and I did not want one party having too much power. When Trump won, I told people, calm down. He'll get qualified people around him. He'll get only the best, the people who know the most. But boy, was I wrong. Let's start out with his Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, who he said he hired because he felt bad for him and he supported him. That was his qualifications for hiring Jeff Sessions as an Attorney General. Watching Republicans change their position on so many issues is just simply mind-boggling. The only way Republicans can go back to who they were is to get a Democrat in office. Think about it now. You can be upset when politicians lie. Remember why you wanted to lock one up for lying? You can be upset when a president talks to dictators. Be outraged when a politician believes Putin over our own national security agencies. You can be against the military breaking up peaceful demonstrations again. You can go back to complaining about presidents golfing too much. Oh, you can also be against nepotism again. And you want an attorney general that works for the people, not the president. You can be outraged when the president blocks people from testifying before Congress. Imagine Bill Clinton saying he wasn't going to talk to Ken Starr because Ken Starr was an angry Republican. I was against Hillary Clinton deleting all her emails. But that's, I'm also against Trump and his administration using WhatsApp so they can delete their messages. My message to both parties is remember Reagan and Tip O'Neill. Working across the aisle is not a bad thing. It is the only way things can work. To save this great country, I would vote for Barney Fife before I would vote for Donald Trump.